let's do this. Let's do this and give me a shot, give me an opportunity. I can show you what I can do with it. Welcome back to another episode of the NightStand HBCU Next. I'm Stan Becton, and our guest today is from Tennessee State, Cam Durley. Cam, how are you doing today?
Man, I'm doing good, man. I'm happy to be here. Happy let me do this.
And I'm glad to have you on the show, Cam. So Cam is an offensive lineman at Tennessee State, one of the best offensive linemen at the HBCU level all around this past year. Tennessee State, of course, is in the Ohio Valley Conference, so you might not have watched them that much, but they did play other HBCUs throughout the season, especially early on, so you can go back and watch some of those HBCU versus HBCU games. But Tennessee State also has some other good games as well throughout the season. So Cam, we're going to start right there with that season. Take me through this last season where you were named first team all OVC, had a new head coach, new offensive coordinator, both with NFL experience. So take me through a little bit about having those men lead you this season and how that played a role in your development.
Man, it was awesome. It was awesome having Eddie George and Hugh Jackson. I mean, both those guys are incredible people, incredible coaches. Very inspirational, but I mean, great football minds. And that is what really, really helped me and everybody else from the team. They broke the game of football down to a level that a lot of us haven't really thought before. And it just made us think about different aspects of the game that you need to learn if you're trying to be a great football player, you're trying to win games. And they and both those coaches and the team that they surrounded themselves with the coaching staffs, I mean, all of them just made each and one of us like just think about different attributes of the game that could take each of our games to different level coverages, different packages, how to read defenses and pick up blitzes and just a whole bunch of things. So like, that's how they helped us as football players and even men too.
Yeah, and you guys did have a successful season. Got to win a couple games there in that OVC, beat Austin Peay when they were a ranked team. So a lot of good wins coming for you guys there. But before you started at Tennessee State, your journey started in Saudi Arabia. So take me through how a child living in Saudi Arabia ends up playing football.
Man, I mean, my mentality has always been the same. I mean, in different continents, different. I mean, just I knew I was always going to find football. It just, when I was in Saudi, I played flag football. And I mean, I was just athletically, there was a gap there sort of thing. I mean, just because a lot of that different athletes played soccer and stuff like that. Anyway, football came back overseas. And I mean, I knew I was going to come back to it eventually. So, I mean, it was just the love I had for the game. I mean, I played many different other sports, but I always knew I was going to come back to football and happy I found it.
Yeah, glad you found it too. Now getting ready for the NFL. You said you played many different sports. I saw you were in a Little League World Series, you and your brother, two of the tallest players in the Little League World Series. So take me through how playing multiple sports helps you on the football field.
Oh, I mean, just the level of athleticism and just I feel like knowledge of knowing about sports in a way kind of makes it easier for transitions in a way of just of course the sports are different, but just if you kind of understand the way, like, kind of how sports work and you kind of can, it's easier transition in a way of knowledge of thinking sort of thing. So, I mean, just all that, I mean, I loved it. I loved the game. So.
Yeah, and your love for the game kind of shows on the field as well. So getting back to the present, you did get a chance to do a couple of postseason games and got to do the HBCU Combine, got to do the HBCU Legacy Bowl. So take me through that experience and going against some of the other top competition at HBCUs.
It was a great experience. I mean, it was just by far, I mean, just being around the guys and soaking up the knowledge of the coaches at the different, at those events. I mean, at the combine, we had historical coaches, NFL coaches, Steve Smith, and it was just, he was running the O-line drills and stuff like that. The way his tidbits of what he gave us really helped us out. And just the whole experience with the combine, it was, I mean, ran by the NFL operations. It was just a whole different feeling sort of thing. And then the HBCU Legacy Bowl, I mean, it was awesome. It was a whole bunch of us playing the game, watching those guys do work and all of us and being around each other, do work in the community like we did. It was incredible. I mean, it was just two amazing experiences that I felt really blessed to be a part of.
Yeah, and that's a great experience and love to see you enjoying yourself out there, especially in those atmospheres. So before you ended up at an HBCU, of course, you did get to do all these HBCU combines and things like that. But before you ended up at HBCU, you went to Kansas. Mm-hmm. So take me through that experience at Kansas and ending up at Tennessee State. Take me through that.
Oh, man, Kansas, yeah. I signed with Kansas at high school. And Kansas was a great school. Kansas was I learned a lot about myself. Coming out of high school, man, I mean, Big 12, Power 5. I got too caught up in that, and I was quite immature at that time. And just I couldn't get together. But, I mean, the biggest thing I learned about myself is take advantage of every opportunity because you never know when you're going to get them. So it was just – once I finally started getting mature, I wanted a fresh start. So I ended up, I hit the portal right when it started too. I mean, I was one of the first few athletes that actually went through the transfer portal. I was amazed with how that whole process was. But I wanted a fresh start, and the coaches at Tennessee State, I mean, there's Rod Reed, Russ Urnfield, O-line coach, Kevin Mashack. He was well-connected in the NFL operations. It was just a great place for me to play right away and just get a fresh start. So, I mean, it was amazing. It was truly amazing how I found Tennessee State and how they found me and just learning about everything. So I found them.
And I know going to Tennessee State was a fresh start for you, but you also had another time you had to get a couple of fresh starts in your career. You did suffer injuries, unfortunately, during your career. I saw you tore your ACL and Achilles. So take me through the perseverance it took for you to battle back through that and still be successful in the football field.
Yeah, man, both those injuries were hard on me mentally, harder to even explain sort of thing. The Achilles was one of the hardest times of my life. Mindset, that's all I can say. My mindset about that, I knew there's no doubt and there's no quitting me at all. I knew to get back from this is just hard work. Takes grind, takes patience, and takes a strong mindset to keep telling yourself that hey, you can get back to where you were even better each time. And it's just telling yourself that and then getting up and doing it and staying consistent with it. So it was one of the hardest times of my life, but it really getting through those was really the best. And I really learned a lot about myself and man, so it was tough. Tell you that.
Yeah, you mentioned mindset a few times there. So with your mindset, of course, you built it by going through that. That plays a role in your mindset. But what is your mindset, would you say, when you strap the pads on now and you're in between those white lines?
Oh, man, it's a different mindset right there. Honestly, I mean, first thing is have fun, have fun sort of thing. And, I mean, dominate, get the job done, win. Whatever the team needs, but I mean, it's a dog-eat-dog world in the between the white lines. It really is, and other people got families. I got families, so I mean, it's in my mind is eat or be eaten sort of thing. So you got to do what you got to do and make sure you're prepared. So it's that kind of mindset. It's a whole different mindset right there. Yeah. So,
yeah, I know how those trenches can be lining up.
Oh, yeah.
You know, yeah. Tight area, back and forth. collisions every play, one of the only positions where you are guaranteed to hit somebody every play out there.
You got to love it. You got to love it. You got to love it.
Yeah, so take me through a little bit of that physicality you play with and how are you able to balance that physicality on the field by also having a little bit of finesse there because you played offensive tackle. So I know you got to have a good little balance of both.
Yeah. Honestly, I mean, my basketball background, really, I think that's where I kind of got my finesse from, sort of thing. And I mean, it's a mentality with that physicality. I mean, it's a mentality. Either you have it or you don't, sort of thing. And I mean, I love it. So I mean, anytime I can show it legally, and it's okay to do it. I mean, come on now. I mean, that's the fun of it right there. So that's when it comes to physicality and the finesse. You have where I'm trying to go, where I'm trying to play at and be great at and win at, you have to have a level of finesse to beat these all-pro guys, Von Miller and Aaron Donald. I mean, it's going to take some finesse to beat a lot of those amazing guys, so you have to have them.
And you mentioned that you have that finesse, you have that physicality, but you also have a chance now to go to that next level. And you mentioned that going to that next level, you got to have it or you don't have it. So what do you have that NFL scouts from all over should know when they're trying to get you on their team, when they're looking to say, I want Cam Durley?
Man, I know it's going to be a process. I know it's going to be a grind, but you get Cam Durley, it's immediate help for your locker room. I'll do anything I need to do to get to for the team, sort of thing. Great, smart player. Everything you can't teach in a player is there, sort of thing. I love the work. So, I mean, let's do this. Let's do this and give me a shot. Give me an opportunity. I can show you what I can do with it. So,
yeah, and that shot's for sure. Looks like it's coming. Draft only a few weeks away. I think less than 30 days. It's April, same month. So, we're looking forward to see where you end up, Cam. And I just want to thank you again for joining the Nightstand HBCU Next. And best of luck to you and your future endeavors.
Thank you, man. Thank you, Stan, for having me. Thank you.